Danny Pedrosa, back on top at last.
Since last year here, when I couldn't race, it's been everything bad and no results. So I'm happy to be back and win a race, but especially happy for my team. All this time I was injured, I couldn't ride well. They still keep on pushing, keep on working very hard. It's been tough, but finally great race, great day and great feeling.
Stoner's condition is perplexing. Last year he was on pole by a mile and then fought that epic battle with Rossi.
The bike's working so well and I'm just not able to ride it hard enough. Not even halfway through, you know, my arms got to a certain point where I couldn't do anything more and I just had to let everybody through and give up basically because there was no way I could outbreak anybody or keep up with anybody the way I was doing it. I take the corners however I can at the moment. As soon as I start getting fatigued, it's just however you can get through them, you got to get through them. My braking points are getting way too early, so I'm losing a lot of time there. And my entry points, I'm not able to enter the corners quite as late to get a good exit. We're going on Monday to find out what's wrong with me.
SACHSENRING, Germany, where Danny Pedrosa's odyssey of pain began a year ago. The pressure's building. Rossi's edging ahead in the championship. Lorenzo's gone four races without a win. There are rumours he'll leave Yamaha at the end of the year. But this is a track which Lorenzo likes, and Rossi does not.
This is not Barcelona. This track is so difficult to overtake and have one, maximum 2 points.
Rossi may not like the track, but it plays to his strength in braking.
Maybe I lose in some flowing part of the track, but I was very strong in the braking.
Where to pass? Two corners to choose from. On the brakes into turn one, or on the brakes into turn 12. Stoner's no real threat to you. Laps count down, Stoner fades, and Lorenzo attacks.
I did some mistakes. The first one was not to attack before. maybe if my attack was come earlier, I could open a little gap. I thought also another mistake. I thought there were more laps to go to the end. So this was my second mistake. Anyway, Valentino has been very brave, and I have to congratulate his victory.
How was your shoulder?
Not still 100%. Maybe after Donington I will start to train again, and I will be more prepared, I think.
Like Lorenzo, the other riders have an eye on their futures. If you want to get hired, you need to get noticed. Starting from the back of the grid, Tony Elias sets out to do just that. So does Marco Melandri. Kawasaki is quitting MotoGP. He needs a new home. You're last on the grid. The future does not look great. This could be your last year in MotoGP. But you love a fight, don't you? Last on the grid, what could be better? More bikes to overtake. How about this? From dead last to sixth. Marco Melandri, three times winner of the German Grand Prix. It's been a while since the last one, in 2002, on an Aprilia 250. But this is a good track for you. Time to summon that old Saxon Ring spirit. From 30...